Hey y'all, what's up? My name is Sonali. Welcome to my channel if you are new. And if you are, definitely go ahead and hit that subscribe button down below because I'm challenging myself to try to get to 25,000 subscribers by November 25th, which is my birthday. So if you like this kind of content, definitely go ahead and help a girl out. But today I'm filming my hat collection and I'm also showing y'all how to style these hats. All of these hats range from $50 to like $150. So let's get started and I can't wait to show you guys how I style them. So I thought we should go ahead and start with the most expensive brand. And you guys could probably guess it because it is such a well-known hat brand. And the brand is Lack of Color. This hat right here is named the Sunny Dip Frey Boater Hat. It is a straw hat that has a bunch of these little holes in it. The thing about Lack of Color hats that I really like is that they actually have different sizes of hats. So you can measure your head with a measuring tape, which I did. And I can't remember what size I was. I'll put it on the screen somewhere here. I'm either a 56 inch or a 57 inch. It was definitely nice to be able to measure my head because obviously like the hats fit perfectly and I didn't have to like get an extender or anything like that for the inside of the hat to fit better. Y'all may be wondering if Lack of Color hats are really worth the hype. And in my personal opinion, I think they are. I honestly haven't even worn them out a ton yet, but I just think the quality is so great and I definitely envision myself having these two hats for a really, really long time and using them and taking photos in them and all that fun stuff. Especially for being like a straw hat, I would say this is pretty sturdy. So let's go ahead and take a look at how I styled this hat. And I would definitely imagine myself wearing it with something more flowy like this jumpsuit. This is from Forever 21. I got it a while ago. Pretty much all my clothes are gonna be not very new, but I just wanted to show you a couple of outfits so that you can get like what vibe I'm going for with these hats. I would also wear this hat with a swimsuit and a cute cover up that's super flowy. I haven't worn this hat too much, so I don't know if it actually gives you a lot of shade when you're in the sun, but I will report back on the vlog when I go to the beach. I wanted to show you guys an outfit option that's not as flowy, but kind of still gives that flowy look. This is from Waif, and I am obsessed with this dress. I'm obsessed with this outfit. Like, oh my god, I feel like so like stylish and cool. This outfit reminds me of something Valerie Starr would wear on Instagram. She has like the cutest feed. It's like so summery, very neutral, and like all about the hats. I love this outfit and I feel like the hat just adds so much more to the outfit. It definitely gives me major like Tulum vibes, even though I've never been there, but on my bucket list. This is the second Lack of Color hat that I got. This is the Palma Wide Fedora, and I know that there is another hat on their site that looks exactly like this, just with a different name. It was actually driving me insane for like 2 weeks because I couldn't figure out the difference, but I did DM their account and ask them, and basically they just said this part, like the top of it, just has like a different kind of style. I honestly can't remember, but I'll try to post the DM here so you guys can like read it and kind of make your decision because they just look so similar. You probably have seen this on almost every Instagram influencer's page because this is like one of their most popular hats, I would say. I honestly found it through a lot of Instagram influencers and they pretty much wear it with like bikinis and cover-ups, a lot of summer vibes. As you can tell, I don't really think this is like a fall hat, but I do need to like flatten out a lot of these hats because I don't know, I feel like it's not supposed to be like curved like that, so I need to figure that out. But also, I don't know if it like looks good like straight on. Like, I think it looks a lot cooler from the side profile and like down. I'm a photographer, so I kind of like just think about all these angles and stuff. But needless to say, I'm obsessed with this hat. It is very well worth the money. It is very sturdy. I will say when I got it in the mail, there was like a string hanging from the front, but I just cut it with an eyebrow scissors and it was totally fine. So let's see how I style this hat.
I paired it with this scarf top that I actually got on Amazon for under 10 bucks. And for all my big boob people out there, you can wear a strapless bra and just have the scarf cover it, or you can just not wear a bra at all. If you tie it tight enough, your boobs will definitely stay up. And then these pants are super cute. They're kind of like that gaucho vibe, you know, like when you were younger and you bought gauchos. They're not the material of like normal gauchos, but they're just like kind of like nice white pants. I definitely think I'm gonna wear this hat a ton in the summer because I just love the look of it. I love the color of it. And I feel like it goes with a lot of outfits. This is a super simple outfit idea that I feel like anyone can put together because you most likely have a white top and brand denim. These pair of jeans are from Zara. They're the high-rise straight leg jeans and I am obsessed. They're like so high-waisted and I love a good high-waisted pair of jeans. This top is actually from Forever 21 and it has like really nice thick straps and I am wearing a bra with it, but I don't have to, which is really nice because it's like that thick material. I low-key look like a farmer. It really just depends on how you look at it, but I think it is definitely a cute summer look.
This is the Big Sky khaki hat from Red Dress Boutique, and I know a lot of stores sell this kind of rancher style hat. I know Urban Outfitters has so many different colors in this hat, but I personally got mine from Red Dress Boutique. I feel like this is probably one of my least favorite hats because I know I'm not gonna wear it as much, but I did want to go ahead and add a darker colored hat to my collection because I feel like everything else is like tan, neutral, white, but I wanted one that I could pick when I want my outfit to be a little bit more contrasted. So let me show you all how I styled this.
I went ahead and paired it with this jumpsuit from Luca and Gray. I got it like my senior spring break, so it's pretty old and I'm pretty sure I got it on sale, but I am obsessed. I actually wear this a ton and I just have to wear like a bandeau and I'm fine. So I either do a black or white bandeau, whatever I'm feeling, whatever's like washed that day. Sometimes I like to wear the hats like this, or most of the times I like to wear it like this. I think it just looks a little bit cooler and not, I don't want to say cheesy, but like not like super Pinteresty. I don't know. I think it looks cute either way, but I think it definitely adds like a cool factor if you wear it like straight on like this. I also think this hat would be perfect for fall since it is like a little bit more of like a brown color. You can wear it with really pretty like tan sweaters or black sweaters. I don't know, anything like that.
This hat is called For Next Time Ivory Hat, and it is from Pink Lily Boutique. This is literally an exact replica of the hat that I just showed you in that more brown color. I definitely think they probably bought it from like a wholesale website and everyone's getting their hats from the same place, but I did really like the idea of having both of the colors just in case my outfit needed a lighter hat or a darker hat.
And I wanted to throw in an outfit that you could wear on a chilly summer night, so I went with this long sleeve black top. I actually tied it so it could be a little bit more cropped just because I am wearing some high-waisted ripped jeans. These are from American Eagle. These were the first ever boyfriend jeans I bought, and I'm still obsessed with them to this day.
The last hat I have for y'all is the Play It Cool Ivory Hat from Red Dress Boutique. Other than the straw hat from Lack of Color, this is my only flat top hat. Pretty much all of the other hats have the rancher style top, which kind of like goes like this, but this obviously you can see it's a flat top hat. I love the style of this hat, but the one thing I wish it didn't have is this freaking bow on the side. I mean, it's kind of cute because it gives it like an extra flair, but I feel like some of the outfits I'm pairing with this specific hat are a little bit more edgy, and I feel like the bow kind of throws it off, if you know what I mean. For the price of this hat, it is extremely sturdy. I just wish that they had different sizes. I'm not sure if they did actually. I can't remember if it's one size fits all or what the deal was, but it is just a tad bit big on me. I feel like it just like falls down over my eyebrows sometimes and it looks a little odd. So I definitely need to look into getting like one of those like extenders that I was talking about. It's just, I think, a little cushion that attaches to your hat so that there is a little bit more material so that, you know, the hat sits up a little higher. So I definitely need to look and see where I can get one of those. I can probably just search it on Amazon, but let's go ahead and see how I styled this last hat.
I actually tied up my hair just to show you guys that you don't have to wear your hair down, but I do highly recommend pulling out these little baby hairs right here just so it doesn't look like straight back because it kind of looks weird like that, but whatever you prefer. This dress is from Urban Outfitters and I really like the high neckline. I think it gives like a really edgy look, but this dress definitely needed to be belted and it didn't come with this belt. And also I definitely would have put a black belt, but I didn't have like a thin black belt. So we're just gonna have to imagine that for now. I have another simple outfit idea for y'all. Just a baggy kind of t-shirt, like a graphic tee or anything like that, and denim shorts. These denim shorts are literally my favorite. I need to go buy like 100 more pairs. Well, they don't have like 100 different colors, but I definitely wanna get them in black. They're from Abercrombie and Fitch. They're, I wanna say like the mom rise shorts, high rise mom, I don't know, something like that. I'll have it linked down below. But this t-shirt I actually thrifted at Goodwill and it says Jameson Irish Whiskey. You definitely don't have to do a graphic tee if you don't want to, if you don't have any. A solid colored shirt would still definitely do the trick. And I think black boots would be really cute with this outfit.
So that wraps up my hat collection. I hope y'all enjoyed this video, and if y'all are interested in any of these hats, they will be linked in the description box down below. Also, if you guys want to see more outfit ideas with hats, I have a few pictures on my Instagram grid already, and I'm definitely going to be posting more because I'm going to go to the beach soon, and I think I'm going to take a couple of these hats. So go ahead and follow me on Instagram. It is so_gnarly without the G. If you made it to the end of this video, comment down below your favorite hat that I showed in this video, and don't forget to subscribe, trying to get that 25K before my birthday, and I will see y'all in my next video. Bye!